egoism is such an incredibly diverse thing that every one of us has our own particular brand of self-love. This we have to bring out, and we have to decide really that we are going to put our affirmation against this. I will not be the slave of that. I will not be the slave of that. So how can you expect me to do this? Because I'm giving up my freedom, you're asking me to. Which freedom are you giving up? Which freedom have you got to get? You have to sacrifice an illusory freedom in order to get one day the real freedom. Get one day the real freedom. In short, the essence of the first line of work always is death and resurrection. Always something has to die so that something can be born. This characterizes it. This is the nature of this whole triad, this process. Return to God is by dying and being born again, death and resurrection. Every little manifestation of self-love in us that dies allows something of a different quality to be born in us. But dying doesn't come just by thinking it would be very nice to be born again. Comes by taking the poison. It is one thing to struggle with one's own laziness, with what your body wants, what your feelings want, and really try to struggle with this. With one's own likes and dislikes. This is very good and necessary thing. It is. No, we never will have the strength to do the real work without that. You will find that you're strong enough now to begin to struggle with yourselves. Only it is most painful work. If it is not painful, it is nothing. If you have the determination and really wish to be free, this is the way. Say from my own experience is that more resolute than one is in this, the quicker something comes, and the reward is without price. It is beyond everything. When one really begins to see that one is free from oneself, that is heaven. Because one's own self is one's hell.